You thought a pandemic was gonna stop me? Start off that Spike Lee dolly shot, because I've been silent for too long. That's right, it's me, Dr. Hadassah Olayinka Ali Young. Google me, then throw your smartphone in the trash. It's making you stupid. See, see, see. 5G was created to infiltrate our brains with the devil's propaganda. TikTok. TikTok, you're wasting your fertile years on the ground. The only 5Gs I recognize is the five bloods. Five triumphant black men going back to steal the oppressor's gold from Asia. Meanwhile, in this country, the only way five black men can gather is if they're playing basketball. I reject verses. Why would I ever celebrate our black icons battling each other? Newsflash, it's us versus them. You know who them is. And why so many Z's in verses? They're trying to put us to sleep. If you cut a dollar bill in half, you know what you'll find on the inside? A blonde hair. Now, they didn't put Harriet Tubman on the $20 bill because they don't want our dollars to be free. Think about it. Tubman breaks down to tub man. They don't wash their legs. Stevie Wonder's not blind. He was just sick of looking at white people. White people wouldn't know a racial reckoning if it pulled up in a Volvo with a kayak on the roof. See, 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 the real racial reckoning will be when black people are reinstated to our true place in society. 106 and Pop. I'm not worried about coronavirus. See, 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 see. White people are the pandemic for which we'll never have a vaccine. Y'all don't hear me? Maybe I have to rap it to you to get you to understand the true learning. Construct is a race, not the other way and back again. You're stupid with a saggy face because you ain't got no college yet. Bars. Now enough with this, Dolly. It's making me dizzy. Where is this thing airing? HBO? What's that stand for? He bought and oppressed us? That's a terrible name for a network.
TV 10 Podcast, episode 0365, with me, Bill Frost.
And me, Tommy Milagro. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, we are still beaming to your wonderful parties, whether you like it or not.
Beaming to your what? You cut out there.
We are beaming to you live to your podcasteries, whether you want us to or not.
All right, podcasteries. That's a word, right?
Yeah, I'm making it a word, and it is now the unofficial title of this episode here.
The Amazing Podcasteries.
I like that. Podcasteries.
Should be a murder podcast, which this is, by the way, in case you just, if you accidentally stumbled upon TV 10, no, it's all about murder, and it is co-hosted by Joe Rogan.
Yes, and more importantly, we're trying to solve the mystery of the death of our ratings. They seem to be plummeting and escalating all at the same time.
Meanwhile, I have to shout out, well, first of all, sponsorship, of course. We are drinking some Sugar House rye whiskey.
Oh, good. Our OG sponsor, Sugar House Distillery.
I'm saying
always
doink, doink, drinking it because, you know, We're merely actors here.
Yes, yes, yes. It's all performance art, Your Honor.
Yeah, just like Alex Jones, this is all performance art.
Yes, and of course, you shouldn't always be listening to idiots like us. We don't know much about COVID or how science works. We just know about TV and maybe once in a while a recipe. But would we ever tell you that you need to drink harder, even though there may be evidence to the contrary, which you're really not paying attention to anyway, because honestly, our numbers bear out you're not even listening to this podcast. We're just performance artists, Your Honor.
Yeah, I do have to shout out a couple of people I know in real life who this week let me know. It's like, hey, I listen to your podcast. I go, the fuck you say? It's true. Yeah, I was like, I was shocked. So I want to give a shout out to Courtney out there and also Matt. There you go. Listen away. I was stunned as fuck to hear this.
Okay. First of all, did they say ha psych afterwards? And more importantly, what was the basis of them saying they listened to our podcast?
They did not pull the psych. Courtney let me know that we mentioned the CBS series from a few years ago that is now on Paramount Plus, Brain Dead, that you should check out on Paramount Plus. It ran for one season and was canceled. It was about alien bugs invading the brains of congressmen and various other White House staffers. It was it came out a few months before the 2016 election, so it was ahead of its time for sure.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
And also,
what was the name of that show again?
Brain Dead.
Brain Dead.
You can watch it on Paramount Plus. And Matt, who is the one of the guitar players for Thunderfist, local legend Thunderfist, let me know. Saw him last night in real life, in person, at a crowded bar with a whole lot of fucking people, just challenging the pandemic.
Wow. Okay.
He's been, let me know. He's been listening harder to the TV Tan podcast. And I go, really? Okay.
Was it followed up with he's inoculated and he's drinking harder to keep the COVID away?
Well, I don't know. I'm vaxxed, so fuck everybody else.
I'm still half vaxxed at this point because certain stores don't want to take the sweet Pfizer, so the Pfizer fizzles out on me.
Oh, you
so
can't.
Whatever.
You can't mix it up with some J&J.
Apparently not. Apparently, it would be bad. Hmm. Meanwhile, I've managed to drink vodka and gin at the same time, supposedly,
allegedly,
and therefore, I haven't suffered any ill effects. I still feel smart. SMRT, that's how you say smart.
Yeah, yeah.
So.
So we actually do have some listeners out there, which is as shocking to me as it is to you.
But you know what else? We need to turn to our listener bag.
Oh, what? Okay,
oh,
what
you
do
didn't
we got?
Realize.
I must have gotten by me.
Let me just get into our jingle of our listener bags, our listener bags. Someone will send us a listener in our bag.
That's some lyrical genius there, okay?
That's exactly what this show pays for. Anyway, it's from our good friend, Dr. Paul White.
Oh.
He writes to us, "Hello, Bill and Tommy. Going old school." Wow, odd to think email.
Oh, yeah, okay, yeah. I remember this, okay.
Yes. "So glad a Black Lady sketch show is back. Curious as how they handle the event this time. It is what I need to see after real time. If not for some of the guests and discussions outside of Bill Maher, plus a habit for us on Fridays, I would have stopped watching years ago. My wife usually falls asleep during it now. Last week, he was praising President Biden's age after making fun of his age in the past few years and calls those who do so the dumb ones now." And yeah, I have to agree with you, Dr. White. I think Mr. Kerry Jackson has even called out that he's starting to become that grumpy old man at this point.
Oh, he's already there.
Yeah, of course, not all of us can go to the Golden Grotto with Hef. So it's a little hard to nowadays unless you've got zombie Hef. I digress.
Yeah.
Anyway,
yeah.
He continues. "You're mentioning that United Shades starts on Sunday got me thinking of some changes the HBO could do. You know, he bought and owned us network."
I'd never heard that one before, but it's a good one.
Yeah, we'll have to explain that in a minute for our new listeners, you know, one or two of you. With AT&T owning all Turner/CNN/HBO/Comedy Central, how about one? Let's give John Oliver more time on Sunday. Go ahead and make it an hour show. Two.
You think John Oliver can sustain that rage for an hour?
Yes, he's British. He can pull it off.
Okay. All right.
Two. Let's allow Mr. Martin to do his stand up that he loves so much and put Trevor Noah in that spot. Not giving up Daily Show though. So there is still an interview style show. Or maybe give it to Sarah Silverman. I love this.
Yeah.
Three, have HBO uncensored airings of United Shades and Full Frontal. Expand her show to an hour there.
There's an idea. Yeah.
Yeah. Four, now this one's going to be a reach. maybe have politically reactive podcast, W. Kamau Bell and Harry Kondalabu, on HBO, which basically is totally biased. He is right, you know.
Yeah, okay.
Five for CNN after for CNN after Mr. Rick Santorum's America Culture comments that came out today. This was written back on Monday, by the way. He needs to go. Been long past time.
Oh, yeah.
And he follows up with, The Nevers is intriguing. Mayor of Easttown is in the DVR. Getting into Clarice and the Equalizer soon. Loving Bird Girl. Once the semester ends, soon, I will be binging the Marvel Disney Plus shows. I am slowly working my way out of just news / political shows all the time. And he signs, well, actually, let me pause here. Because you see, folks, the new listeners, the one or two of you that are out there, we used to have this thing on our show, on TV 10 Podcast, where we would say, our show is not safe for work. I don't know why the fuck you cunts couldn't figure that one out, but crazy enough. However, we had to say that NSFW usually means, and it could be a number of things, like no sandwich for wombats, or nipple sing for winter, or something like that. With Dr. White, it is never showing frontal weaponry.
Hmm. Good one.
That could be another title here.
All right, got a couple of answers for a couple of those in there. Okay. Comedy Central is only partially owned by Warner Brothers. It's mostly owned by Viacom CBS. So it might be kind of a trick to get Trevor Noah over into HBO territory. But as for replacing Bill Maher, I think we have an in-house solution. Robin Thede.
Ooh. Okay, explain to our new listeners.
Robin Thede used to host The Rundown, which was kind of a political / news show, half hour on BET years ago, which got canceled. But it was really cool. You can look it up on YouTube. There's some clips up there. But she eventually bounced back with the Black Lady Sketch Show, which is fucking hilarious. But they only produce like so many episodes a year, so I think she could work in hosting Real Time with Robin Thede. Pretty easily.
And as much as I love the idea of W. Kamau Bell and Harry Kondalabu doing Total Bias 2.0, the problem is it's another podcast that has their own TV show before us. Can't have that.
Yeah, there's far too many of those.
Yeah. But everything else, though, I mean, thankfully, the TV news executives listen to us heartily and know this is the show to really pick and choose what great ideas they can put into their TV lineup.
Yeah. And I got a whole lot of new stuff coming our way this week on the TV box. Starting with a Tuesday, May 4th, you know, May the 4th, Star Wars, The Bad Batch on Disney Plus.
Yay!
I don't know much about the Star Wars Clone Wars animated world, but I know this is something to do with the Clone Wars.
So Bad Batch, I know a little bit about.
Good,
this.
I'm glad somebody here knows something about this show.
So this the Bad Batch were a cast of characters from Star Wars: The Clone Wars, which was on Cartoon Network before it became Disney Plus proper there. They were Star Wars' answer to the Dirty Dozen, except, you know, not.
Yeah.
But it offered a different spin off of the clone troopers, and they're imperfect, but they get the job done.
Okay.
Now, as far as how this is going to parlay, because, and the reason I'm kind of wondering about this is because with the Clone Wars, there was this weird thing involving a bunch of, you know, this whole Empire Order 66 thing. But now you get, I don't know, this could be something that continues in that same vein before the Empire hits, or maybe it's something afterwards in the Star Wars Rebels cartoon lineup there. The important thing is, it's okay, kids. It's not George Lucas doing this. It's Dave Filoni more than anything else.
Okay. All right.
So calm that down. It'll be fine.
Yeah. So speaking of make-believe stuff from space, The Secret of Skinwalker Ranch has a second season on History Channel beginning May 4th on Tuesday. Attention, Merlot, our third listener.
Merlot alert. We have a Merlot alert. This is not a drill.
Yeah, so Skinwalker Ranch down there in the Uinta Basins right here in Utah. Yeah, they spent like, what, 8 episodes last year finding fucking nothing other than they had a couple ranch hands who got headaches when they got around certain parts of the ranch. And it's like, therefore, that's proof that there's aliens here or some shit. So basically, they spent eight episodes finding nothing. And so I think here we'll get another 8 episodes of them finding nothing.
And
I'm gonna and I'm probably gonna watch it like an idiot, yeah, like I did the first season.
What channel is this on?
That's on the History Channel.
Okay, so the history is
the Doink Doink History Channel.
Yeah, so it's historic in the fact that somebody's watching this.
Yeah,
so.
Apparently enough people watched it. They said, "Hey, let's do another season of that."
Fine. All right.
Yeah, coming up on Wednesday, I'm mentioning this only because Paul Giamatti is narrating this. It's The Sons of Sam, A Descent into Darkness on Netflix. It's a docuseries about a journalist, Maury Terry, who followed the, who basically became obsessed with the Son of Sam case, and he's still convinced that it's linked to a satanic cult. And so here's a murder show for you.
Okay.
On the Netflix.
So, are we saying that there's more than one Berkowitz out there? Or
I don't know. I'm going to have to watch to find out.
So, oh, actually, I have some trouble with that title, The Sons of Sam.
Yeah.
Can we just call for what it is, Breaking Berkowitz?
It was right in front of them. How did they not see it? What the fuck?
And I am titling it as we speak.
Yeah.
Because...
Yeah. On Thursday, here's something cool. It's on Paramount Plus, so you got to have that, you Trekkies out there. From the cradle to the stage, or from cradle to stage, or yeah, that's what it's called. It is a story. It's based on the story by Virginia Grohl, mother of Dave Grohl. The book titled "Cradle to Stage: Stories from the Mothers Who Rocked and Raised Rock Stars." This is a docuseries about various rock stars and their moms. First episode, more Utah interest here. Dan Reynolds of Imagine Dragons and his mom, Christine Reynolds.
Really?
Yep.
Okay.
Musically, can't fucking stand Imagine Dragons, but I think Dan Reynolds is pretty cool, so I will probably check this out.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong. I think I saw this in our listener bag somewhere if I dig deep down. Isn't there also another Dave Grohl directed project, What Drives Us, I want to say?
Yeah, that's out there somewhere.
Okay. All right. It's no Sonic Highways, but it looks like it could be interesting, but I thought you'd have more details on that.
So. Yeah, maybe next time. That's one of those things I know about, and I did not look into it, because Dave Grohl is just too... he puts out too much shit for me to keep up with.
It's a tough thing when you are just a musical archivist and you want to say, look, dude, here's some cool stuff.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
You know what would be really good?
If I had Dave Grohl's money, I'd probably be doing the same thing.
You know what would be real cool? And here's a here's an idea. Mostly I'm directing this at MTV and the Viacom executives. What if you got Questlove from The Roots and David Grohl and you have them... just jam on some wonderful music together while still giving some history of how rock really occurs. So, you know, music involved with your television?
Nah, those days are gone. Yeah, what drives this is it's a documentary out there now, and where can you get a hold of this sucker?
Yeah, I just saw it, and I want to say it was like HBO Max, because You know, well, they've been in the docking.
You're going to have to pay for it. It's one of those video on demand things. It's technically a theatrical release that is you'll have to pay for it through like Amazon Prime Video or something.
Just to clarify that last sentence there, is it more you're going to have to pay for it or you're going to have to pay for it?
Yeah, more of the latter.
Okay. Yeah. It kind of feels foreboding anyway.
Yeah. And also coming up this week on Thursday on HBO Max, That Damn Michael Che. Yeah, Weekend Update's own Saturday Night Live. Michael Che has a new sketch comedy show where he has bringing in various people from SNL like Cecily Strong and Heidi Gardner and, of course, Colin Jost. And, yeah, so it's going to be another one of those. It's going to be another Listen, Whitey. One of these much needed Listen Whitey shows.
That's our new title as well. Listen,
because Whitey. America has proven time and time and time again the Whitey don't listen. Therefore, Whitey's going to have to get talked to some more.
Maybe Whitey listen harder.
Whitey listen harder. Maybe. Yeah.
Yeah, that might be a better title.
Though. Yeah, the another Thursday premiere on Vice. I'll just mention this before we get to the sports report. The Dark Side of the Ring season 3. That's all I'm going to say. I'm giving you the rest of it here. But Friday is the second season of Mythic Quest: Raven's Banquet on Apple TV Plus. A really fucking funny show. You should check out. This is Rob McElhenney from It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia, and also in here is F. Murray Abraham, and it's about a video game company, and it's really fucking funny. I highly recommend it. And also, third and final season of 80 Bryant's Shrill premieres on Hulu on Friday.
Oh. Okay.
And that's why you haven't seen much 80 Bryant on Saturday Night Live this season, because she's been busy finishing up her series there. And would you believe yet another superhero show?
Yeah.
Yeah, this is on Netflix. It's called Jupiter's Legacy. It's about a first generation of superheroes led by Josh Duhamel and Leslie Bibb. And now their children, they've got to take over for them. And it looks pretty dark from what I've seen of it so far. It doesn't look like... what was that show movie from several years ago? That Superhero Academy movie. It was I think it was like a Disney movie.
Yeah. It was with Kurt Russell.
Yeah.
And Bruce Campbell. My super high school life.
Yeah. It looks to be much darker than that. And speaking of the darkest timeline, Elon Musk hosts Saturday Night Live on Saturday with musical guest Miley Cyrus.
We've talked about this.
So I can't wait to see this go down in flames.
Some men want to watch the world burn.
Yeah, and on Sunday, premiere of a new Showtime series. This is another. We're taking somebody from the internet and trying to translate them to TV. This is Zwei, Ziwe. She is a comedian, performer. Multimedia star who's blown up big on Instagram, and now she has a combination of sketches and interviews and guest stars, and it's kind of all over the place, but seems to work. She was previously a writer for Daisus and Marrow, and she's also been a voice on Our Cartoon Precedent and Tuning Out the News, and so yeah, she's legit, and this should be interesting to see how this show works, because it looks really different than your usual sketch comedy show.
Okay, so it's Zwei, is it?
Zwei, I believe that's how it's pronounced. Ziwe, yeah.
Oh, Ziwe.
Yes,
okay.
Yeah.
All right.
All of which brings us to the sports report.
Well, just to hit the music and we'll get started.
And sports with Tommy Milagro. Go, team!
From the sports desk of the TV 10 podcast, we deliver to you only the sport of professional wrestling, but you know it's very hard to be humble about the work I do for SlamWrestling.net. Thankfully, I have an MBA.
Drink.
And a lot of a couple of things just to bring up here, and we're going to start off with the WWE here. Specifically, Peacock. Peacock has announced that they have added 9 million new members in the first 3 months of 2021. Peacock now has 42 million members in the United States, and Peacock is contributing this surge to The Office and the WWE arriving on the service. In February, WWE announced that the network had 1.5 million paid subscribers. And since there are three tiers to Peacock, it is not known how many of the 9 million are paid subscribers. So,
well,
this is me,
you can only get the WWE stuff on the two paid tiers, right? They don't give it away on the free tier.
Right. Yeah, so I'm going to say maybe a third, but how much of that? That's a whole different story right there.
Yeah, I will drop a little piece of advice here. If you are subscribing to any streaming service that has one with ads and one without, always spend the extra bucks and go the without ads. Just do it for your own peace of mind. You'll thank me.
And that was another Frost Talk.
Yeah.
Sorry. Frost tip.
Yeah, there you go.
but also along the lines of WWE, and this goes into the work I do recapping for Major League Wrestling. Did I mention that I do some recaps for Slam Wrestling for shows like Major League Wrestling? But again, not many with an NBA can do that.
No big deal. No big deal. That is slamwrestling.net, by the way.
That's all right. Thank you. And drink. But here's what you need to know. It's been reported, and it was reported by a Wrestling Observer, that WWE is in talks to work with Major League Wrestling. So it's going to be supposedly a developmental type of system. And this could work where certain wrestlers that are not being utilized either in the WWE or NXT could go down to Major League Wrestling and get some TV time. This is nothing new. This has been done before with currently Evolve Wrestling and before that ECW in the later years of the 90s. How much or how little is this going to happen? We're going to have to wait and see how that develops. But we also have to mention with Major League Wrestling, they are now on Vice TV, which you can catch on Saturdays at noon Eastern. However, this first episode mostly just focused on episodes from last year at around this time. So it's not going to be a big deal for the hardcore MLW fans, but for new people to see some of the talent like Marshall Von Erich of the famed Von Erichs going up against Maxwell Jacob Friedman, MJF, now currently with AEW, pretty cool to see how that develops right there. They're going to probably do this the same way Impact Wrestling first started the month with Access TV. They're just going to show clips of shows they did in the past, and then probably next month they'll come up to speed with brand new shows. Or maybe, if I'm going to be honest, they'll probably get started somewhere in July, because that's when they're going to have their first tapings at in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. So that will be very interesting to see how that develops right there. But in the meantime, I will definitely say you're going to have to catch A&E biographies if you want to. As we're recording live on air this Sunday, I'm going to be covering on Macho Man Randy Savage. I'm curious to see how much or how little they're going to talk about Macho Man's life, only because, and you saw this as well, Bill, season one of Dark Side of the Ring, I felt got more involved into the personal life of Macho Man Randy Savage than any other biography has to date.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
And I will say, with Vice TV, with a few hiccups here and there, their Dark Side of the Ring series really really has a tendency to dive deep. We're talking balls deep, folks, into whatever story there was in professional wrestling, from the murder of Gino Hernandez to Dino Bravo's involvement with the Montreal mob. No, the real mob, not the not the Riverdale shit you see before. And, of course, what happened to Owen Hart and other things. Season 3, I didn't think they were going to tell anything new, but this season, yeah, they're starting off fucking strong. Last season, they started off with a two-parter on Chris Benoit. This season, they're starting with Brian Pillman, the loose cannon himself. Now, do you know about Brian Pillman, Mr. Frost?
Nope, you must enlighten me.
Brian Pillman, a very small, well, small by wrestling standards, man, who really made a name for himself, not only being a great talker, but a high flyer for the late 80s, early 90s. But then he went in a different direction. This was around the early to middle 90s, that when he wasn't being utilized as much by WCW, started to portray a loose cannon persona, and it got to the point where you couldn't tell where fiction and real life, it was the cutoff line. He broke the fourth wall time and time again. It should be a very fascinating story, and apparently you can catch Dark Side of the Ring, part one of Brian Pillman, on YouTube right now. We'll make sure that this gets linked up to our interwebs very shortly once this episode drops. And, oh, did I mention, in addition to me covering AEW Biographies Macho Man, I'm going to be covering Brian Pillman as well.
Oh, okay.
Yes, so I'll be covering Brian Pillman 1 and 2, parts 1 and 2, as well as the ultra-violence that is Nick Gage. And for those of you who are wondering, why is Nick Gage such an important name? Well, this is a guy who almost fucking cut up David Arquette in a death match. So,
if only he'd finished the job.
Oh, come on. David Arquette has suffered enough, but enough about Courtney Cox.
Yeah.
And with that said, just know that wrestling is still real to us, damn it, because it's sports.
It's sports with Tommy Milagro. Go team.
So what I'm basically saying is, I'm going to be fucking busy this week.
Oh, that right, yes. That right in life.
You know this all too well.
All too goddamn well, yes. And got some news on we mentioned the unasked for revival of Dexter on Showtime a while ago. We have some more details about the revival series, which I believe is coming in the fall of this year.
Okay.
When we left off, Dexter had fucked off out of Florida, and he was off being a lumberjack somewhere in Oregon.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. But now it looks like Dexter's back on the East Coast for season 9. He's working, he's living in Iron Lake, New York. I don't know where that is, or even if it's a real place, but it looks like he's working in a bait and tackle shop.
Mm. There's a lot of jokes in there.
Oh,
I'm
yeah.
not going to touch them. I'm just going to let them sit. And let them bloom. On
yeah, apparently he's working at a place called Fred's Fish and Game, which is strategically placed between a gun shop and a bait and tackle store. So, you know, going to have plenty of supplies there for killing. And it looks like the new big bad of the season will be the mayor of this town, Iron Lake, Clancy Brown, who's fucking fantastic. And at least we'll have a good villain.
Sign me up. I'm there.
Oh,
I'm
yeah.
good.
And we might also see the return of Jennifer Carpenter taking the place of his dad as the old dark passenger.
Mm,
yeah.
Okay. Either way, having the Kurgan on That is genius.
Yeah. So, and we're here at the point we're going to tell the people what they should be watching harder. What would you recommend out there?
Well, let's see. I just finished this up, and I'm going to tell people right now, if you're not on Amazon Prime and you're not seeing Invincible, is Jupiter's Legacy Superior. Honestly, that is going to be your best choice right there. Also, I'm going to say right now, as far as anything else to watch, Dark Side of the Ring, you definitely have to watch harder.
If you get the Vice channel on whatever your provider dishes out.
Yeah, and I'm also going to say any biographies, especially with the WWE stuff. If you're new to the WWE product and or want to learn some of the old WWE superstars of yesteryear, then that's your jam. Otherwise, softer.
All right. I'm going to second Dr. White's recommendation of Bird Girl.
yes.
I mean, Padgett Brewster is great as Bird Girl, but I'm really loving Nagin Farsad's daughter of Mentok the Mind Taker, Meredith Mind Taker. Oh. Really, really good. Yeah, she doesn't do that, though. I wish she would bring that back. But anyway, also, we haven't talked much about the current fourth season of Good Girls on NBC. Pretty intense. Definitely check that out. The first three are on Netflix. Young Rock is ending, I believe, this week. Keenan already ended. And both of them have been renewed for second seasons, so there will be more of that coming your way.
There is a breaking news here. There is something we should mention that should be a watch harder.
Yeah, and also
on Netflix.
And also Chad on TBS is just fucking hilarious. Nassim Pedraj, she just fucking goes there with it. It's so ridiculous.
Again, the comedy Ricky Gervais wishes he could do.
Oh, yeah. It's full-on cringe comedy, but in a much better way than Ricky Gervais usually pulls off. And,
right, because
yeah,
it involves heart.
Yeah, so that's enough for now. We want to thank Sugar House Distillery for the rye whiskey.
Mm-hmm. And we should also thank our other fine sponsors. That would be Outlaw Distillery. Then, of course, there's Ogden's Own Distillery. The fine purveyors of Five Wives Vodka, Jamie's favorite. I'm writing this down. Make it Jamie's favorite. Then, of course, there is also Madame Paterini Gin. Then, of course, there is also Porter's Fire, Porter's Peanut Butter Whiskey, Porter's Rye. And, of course, there's the Underground, if you want to get underground.
Yeah.
Then, of course, we should thank Bohemian Brewery, who still supplies us with pallets and pallets of beer. Wait a minute. I'm looking at my teddy bear nanigams. Whoa, the 12th basement's been cleared out. You've been doing some drinking, sir.
I've been working on it.
That's good. And again, this is all just a performance art, Your Honor.
Yes.
as far as you know. And, of course, we should also thank our good friend Ivy Boutique, so you can use some glassware or maybe some mixers just to make your drinks bloom. But no matter where you go, until you get vaxxed up here or vaxxed off, whichever, just wear a mask.
Yeah.
Still, do we need to remind you? Come on.
Well, apparently so, yeah. All right, and with that, good night, America.
Well, I better jiggle that handle. It's time to flush.